Hey, what's going on everybody? My name is Sancus and in this video we're going to take a look at some drum and bass. I'm going to go for some nice and melodic stuff and I'm going to go ahead and start with the drum selection. First I'm just going to bring the BPM up to 175, which is the drum and bass kind of tempo. And I'm going to go ahead and use the BHK samples. They're definitely focused on a lot of drum and bass stuff, and I'm going to use their Christmas pack, find a kick to use. Something like that, and nice snare as well. And I'm gonna go ahead and create a kind of standard drum and bass drum pattern. So very kind of standard drum and bass drum pattern. Just gonna send these into the mixer channel so I can turn them down a bit. Now I'm gonna look for some hi-hats. Just gonna use an open hi-hat here. And some closed hi-hats. And try and create this little drum and bass shuffle. So I'm gonna just bring this hi-hat over here, and this hi-hat over here to the side, and copy this one back in. Insert it over here as well. So here we have this nice little hi-hat shuffle. That's gonna create a nice It's gonna create a nice little feel, well, the rushing feel that you hear from drum and bass, that fast-paced shuffle. And I'm gonna bring this hi-hat, this open hi-hat here on the kick at the beginning here and the snare, and then on every other snare, and then back on the first kick here. Just to kind of create a bit of a splashing effect on top of those drums, and I'll send these cymbals into my channel mixer as well. Now what I like to do is take another kind of break beat and layer it up with that. So we got some breaks under this Christmas free pack here. You can also go into this pack and just find a nice little hi-hat layer and kind of chop that up. Something like that will do. So I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger here. I'm gonna take this first part here and just kind of use that first part. So of course I'm going to send that in as well and mix it into the background a little bit. I'm also going to go ahead and just high pass it a bit and make it a bit, boost the mids up a little bit. It's very bright. And I'm going to take all these hi-hats over here as well, the closed hi-hats, and just send them into another mixer group. So I'll route them to that track only. And I'm gonna compress them a bit with the fruity limiter. And I'm gonna go ahead and high pass those as well. So you can't really hear the loop, but it's still there in the background and just kind of fills it out a little bit. And that's pretty much the drums for now. I think anything else besides that should be added later when we have a little bit more in the track. I'm just gonna select this and press Ctrl B and paste it in. Now there's a couple of ways to approach this. Sometimes I like to start with the bass and work my way up in terms of sounds that occupy certain frequencies, but I think in this case I'm going to create one sound and then create kind of a riff with that, and have that riff repeat, and then have the sounds underneath that main riff just change up and change in progression, and kind of create this ever-evolving progression of melody. So I can either make a kind of leady sound or more of a plucky sound. I'm gonna go ahead and actually use contact for this. I'm gonna load up Evolve Mutations, which is still installed into my FL Studio 11, so gotta do this. But I'm gonna go to my instruments and tonality and effects, melodic, and I'm gonna use this music box here. It can be found in other synths. This is just for me the quickest and easiest way to find it. So I'm going to go ahead and just go to the master effects and reverb, and I'm going to take off the reverb and the delay as well, so we get this dry sound. And I'll take the release down a little bit. Now I'll go ahead and just create a kind of basic melody. I think I'll have the track be in G. I really like G, I use it all the time. It's either G, F, or E that I use, or A. So we'll make it in G. I'm not gonna, I'm gonna create the first note on G here. And then I'm gonna go up into the second octave and play between D and E flat. So let me go ahead and paste this over, and hearing it being repeated and looped usually helps me kind of listen and hear what I should change and kind of get the groove in my head a little bit. And this last one over here I'll make unique, and I'll make this one a little bit different. Maybe bring this G up to A. And then start playing around with the F a bit. Maybe I will bring this one to the D. Thank you. So that's starting to sound kind of solid. I'm just going to send this in and apply my own effects. Wasn't really a fan of the reverb and delay that was on there. Kind of prefer the stock FL Studio ones, so I'm going to go ahead and insert the reverb and the EQ2 before that and just kind of EQ it a bit. I'm just going to insert the limiter and just give it a simple gain boost. I'm going to go ahead and just select these four patterns and merge them together. So to do that, just select them, go to this menu, edit and merge pattern clips. So I can paste it over and I can take all these notes and layer it up with another synth. For this next synth, I'm just going to use Serum, and I'm going to change this to one of these shapes. I'm just going to have this one have a bit of modulation and just kind of layer it up with the other sound. I'm going to give this one a lot of voices and detune it a bit. They'll both go to the same filter, which I'll just turn up for now so I can hear the sound a bit better. I'm going to use this LFO1 on the envelope mode and just kind of create this sort of curve and use this for modulating. Something like this, maybe bring it up another octave and bring this one down a bit. Now I'm going to take envelope 2 and apply this to the cutoff and make it a bit plucky. And I'll go to the hyperdimension expansion. I'm just going to use the hyper and the distortion. I'm going to use the downsampling mode. Just kind of emphasize that a high end, crisp it up a bit with downsampling. And give it a bit of delay with this delay effects here and just kind of increase the wet and the feedback a bit. And now I'm gonna give it a bit of reverb as well. Maybe adjust this feedback a bit, bring this back down. So a very simple kind of pluck, but that's going to layer with the music box and make it feel a bit more full. Now I'm going to work my way down and I'm just going to create some chords. Gonna use 3XOSC for that. Just gonna use these three oscillators and detune two of them down by two octaves and the first one up by, actually no, down by two octaves and these down by one octave and just detune the second ones a bit. Well, the second and the third one. I'm gonna make them all sawtooth. So now we get a nice kind of lush super saw, and I'm just gonna actually send it in first and turn it down because it's quite loud. So make it sit kind of underneath it and maybe apply some effects to it afterwards. And I'm gonna have the chord progression kind of switch up over the course of this loop. That might actually be a bit much detuning, so I'm going to take it down a bit. So I'm just gonna have the chord progression follow this kind of structure, or kind of playing almost when the kick is playing. So now I have this kind of chord progression loop here, and I'm just going to paste it back in over here. So this kind of repeats three times and then changes up at the end, but this one is going to change up every bar. So I'm just going to take this basic G minor and just start transposing some of these and create different chords. So this last note may need a bit of fixing here. And this note, this chord here could use a bit of fixing. Now I'm going to make this second pattern unique and change the chords for this as well. Actually, I think I'm going to go ahead and just mute this for now and create the bass first, and I think we'll have more control and accuracy over what the progression should be with the bass, since that's a quite important part of drum and bass. I'll just start with a very basic kind of saw here. We'll be right back. copy this back over because the progression is starting to be a little bit longer than I anticipated. So that's kind of starting to get there. Got a pretty decent progression here. All I really did was just listen to it and think in my mind what my ears think should come next. Doesn't really make sense the way I phrased that, but I think you get what I mean. Just kind of listen to what I imagine should come after a certain note and just kind of go from there. So now we can start taking these chords and maybe match that progression to make this sound a bit more appropriate. It's also a bit bright. What I'll do is I'm actually gonna low pass this and take away a lot of those low frequencies and high frequencies and low frequencies here. Now this is all going by ear really, and in this case I would rather trust my ears than trying to think of, hey, what chord progression in music terms fits next. I'm just gonna go by ear, and if it sounds right and if it harmonizes well, then we're on the right path. Now kind of technically this F sharp doesn't really fit into the G minor scale, but in this case I think we can borrow a note or chord from another scale, because I think it actually kind of sounds cool. Maybe just not to your ear, maybe to my ear, I don't know, I think it sounds cool. I'm gonna let this loop over one more time. Gotta find the right chord for this. So okay, maybe this could be layered with something else, or maybe add a lead to this. Gonna go ahead to these saws, and I'm gonna make them a bit pluckier. So I'm gonna take the sustain down, the release down a bit, the hold all the way down, and the decay down. Alright, cool. Now let's go ahead and find that bass and work on this a bit. I'm gonna go ahead and send that in. I'm gonna low pass it. So what I'll do in this patch is I'll add the sub to this, and I'm gonna go and edit this. Gonna go to process and remove fundamental, which is gonna remove the fundamental note, which is gonna sit right where the sub bass is. So this is just gonna give it a bit of harmonics with the sine wave, but most of the fundamental is gonna be coming from the sub bass. So you can see it changed it, and if we play without the sub bass, there's like basically no fundamental note. So you can see the difference how I removed the note from down here where the sub would play. So now it should play nicely together. Also that this bass should get kind of chopped and follow the same rhythm as the chords. I think I'll just leave it the way it was for now. I'm gonna actually go ahead and take the kick and just slightly sidechain some of these elements, and especially the bass a bit more than the other elements. Also thinking about replacing the kick, kind of changed my mind on that kick, when kind of more of a clean kick, something like this. And I'm going to go ahead and take these melodic elements that we have and send them all into the keys group over here so I can get them ready to be sidechained. So same thing, just going to sidechain them with a limiter and have the kick sidechain this group and select that bass drum and just kind of give it a bit of a pumping effect. And I'm also gonna go ahead and take this and maybe make it a bit slower, a bit more chilled, since the chords are playing quite fast. I'll take all these last notes over here and just gonna kind of extend them. As a matter of fact, I'll extend all of these, so I'll just press Ctrl and L. Maybe work on this patch a bit more, maybe make it a bit more detuned now. Something that could also maybe sound kind of cool is adding this bandpass to it with a bit of LFO here. Alright, so I'm just going to turn the bass down a little bit here. Now I can add a little bit of reverb to this super saw kind of chord progression here, and maybe a bit of chorus as well, maybe make it a bit more washed out. This bass over here is dropping down too late as well, just fix that. Now I think I'm gonna add a little lead to this. Gonna go ahead and bring up Serum once again and create one of my favorite little wobbly, not wobbly, talky leads with the formant filter. So I'm going to send it in as well here, channel routing, and route this to selected and send it into the keys group and try to come up with a nice little lead and maybe have it progress a little bit differently from the bass notes and just kind of come up with something that harmonizes well with what we have. So basically just copying and over pasting it, changing the notes and trying to have this progress and evolve and not just repeat over and over. The pattern is going to repeat, but the note progression is not going to repeat. Well, it's going to repeat here in this sense, but every four bars I want to try to have some different kind of progression. So if you can remember, this is where we had the borrowed note, the F sharp. Sounds a bit weird, sounds a bit off, but for some reason I kind of like it, so I'm going to go ahead and keep this borrowed chord in there, this borrowed note that we have. So I think here in this last part, this last segment, I'm going to try and mix it up a bit and change the rhythm a bit. Try and stick to the rhythm, but kind of change it around a bit and make it a bit unique. Alright, so got this going here. Gonna go ahead and work on a patch, just tweak it a little bit more. Whoops, what did I do? I accidentally inserted it here. I'm gonna go ahead and go back to the distortion and maybe add a bit of noise to this. Also gonna bring this LFO onto the coarse pitch and turn it down over here and have the aux source be macro 1. So now I can engage some vibrato whenever the longer notes appear. Actually, scratch that, I'm gonna use a different LFO. Not sure why I had the sub engaged there, but I guess I did. Alright, so we're at LFO 2. Gonna go to the matrix and turn this down a bit. And again, I'm gonna make it controllable with macro 1. Alright, so I'm gonna create an automation clip for this macro, and I'm gonna have the vibrato engage on the longer notes, such as this one. And then restart for the next longer note. Kind of make it fade in a bit slower on these longer notes, and then a bit faster on the shorter longer notes, kind of like this. And since the pattern pretty much repeats, we can use this again. Alright, gonna go back into this patch one more time and just add another filter here at the end. Gonna use the high pass 12 filter, and I'm gonna use the LFO 1 on it. Gonna modulate both the cutoff and the frequency to create a bit more movement in the patch. Maybe I will create a new LFO for this as well and just use an envelope. Take this back down. Maybe bring it back onto triggered and bring this down and just create something like this. Also gonna stack the voices and detune it a bit, bring the detune down. Maybe detune it a bit more. Gonna go ahead and EQ this a bit. Now I'm gonna insert a bit of distortion with the pretty fast distortion, just crunch it up a tiny bit. I'm gonna bring the mix down, make it not as overbearing. Could even go back into this MIDI and maybe change around some of these notes or add some pitch bends. Okay, I'm gonna take this detune back off and the 16 voices, and I'm just gonna add a bit of reverb, make it fit into the space a bit. Maybe try a square wave for this. So I'm just gonna use the squareify function here with singles. Make it decay a bit. this square here with a saw. I'm going to add the LFO2 to the coarse pitch as well and do the same kind of setup for the vibrato. Maybe try adding the perfect fifth to it. I'll bring it back down to zero. I think it's pretty good for now. Pretty decent groove here, pretty decent melody. Perhaps this section gets a bit out of groove or out of rhythm, but it's okay, it can always be adjusted very easily. So something like that, that's pretty much how I would go about creating just a basic loop for drum and bass, and take something like this and split it up, maybe layer it with different things, and it can take something like this in a whole bunch of directions. So thank you very much for joining me for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and with that being said, you guys have a good one.